In life, we're going to face some challenges. In life, we're going to have some struggles. In life, we're going to have some things that are not going to always go our way. But if we trust in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as we say, then we know that it's all in God's hands.
Yes.
That God is yet in control. That God is working behind the scenes trying to change some things that are happening in our lives. But all he's asking for us is to merely trust in him and believe that he is in control. Yes, we know that God has designed something magnificent, marvelous to happen in our lives. And also we know that God has designed for some bad things to come our way as well. But either way, God says for us to keep on pressing, to keep on believing, to go back to that box of chocolate and keep on pressing on and moving to the next piece. And as we move on to that next piece, we see that what God has in store for us is greater than that first piece that we once received. Life is like that sometimes. Things don't always happen the way that we want it to happen, but we know that God is still in control.
Yes.
Sometimes we feel trapped on a boat. Or some may say who are here on this island, we feel trapped on the island. In the middle of a sea. In the middle of an unfamiliar place. In the middle of the sea as the storm and our life is tossing us to and fro. The waves of life are knocking us around, making us drag and carry on extra bags while we're enduring our storm. You peer into the darkness while you're in this storm and you're seeking for hope.
Yeah.
You're looking for a shiny day. You're looking through to come through your storm. But all you see, if you're truly going through your storm, is that dark sky, those dark clouds, that thunder and that lightning that is shaking your faith, shaking your mood, shaking what you are trusting and believing in. And we know those waves and those challenges of life continue to get stronger and stronger. You may have storms on your job. You may have storms in your home. You may have storms everywhere you go. You may have trouble in your life from the beginning to the end. But we know our God, is yet an awesome God.
Yes, he is.
Worthy of all the praise and honor given unto his name.
Yes.
And if we're going to live in this life, we know that we're going to have to endure some challenges and face some things that God has set in our path for us to endure. But as I always say, we have to learn to count it all joy. And to learn that those things are just building us up to where God has purpose for us to be. Oh, but if you have Jesus with you, church, you have the greatest gift of it all. As the disciples had Jesus on the boat with them, they had the greatest living thing with them.
Yes.
They had the master of the universe. As many people back in my time say He-Man was the master of the universe.
Well,
but we know that our God is truly the master of this universe.
Yes, he is.
He can be sleep anywhere on this earth and still bring us through our storm.
Yes.
I'm convinced that he can pull us out of a fiery furnace, if need be, to show us that he is still an awesome God.
Yes, he is.
Why? Because the Savior is awesome. His powers are awesome. And his grace and mercy is continuing to be awesome in each and every one of our lives here today.
Yes,
amen. But if we were on that boat, we knew that our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, was with us.
Yes, he is.
That he wasn't going to let anything, any hurt, harm, or danger come our way. We know that Jesus would have carried us on through. Because we know that there is always a light at the end of every tunnel. And that light is always our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Jesus' plans for our lives does not include the calming of the storm for us at all times. We see that Jesus rebuked the waves, just like he rebukes those things that you are doing wrong in your life. Those things that you're not giving unto him, he is rebuking those things.
Yes.
Because he knows just what we need.
Yes.
Look at the rebuke of the waves once again. And we know how Jesus just, by just speaking out of his mouth, those waves just cease. They calm down. And the disciples were back in peace. But at that time, they were like, Jesus was like, oh, ye of little faith. You trust for me to do everything else, you were with me through all the miracles I performed. But you didn't trust me while I was yet in the midst of your presence on the boat. He became upset that he had to calm the waves for them to see that they had the greatest of the greatest with them. I believe that the storm that night was something he had planned to intercede in their life. That Jesus set that storm in place to just to stir their faith up, to shake them up just a little bit. Like many of us need to be shaken every now and then.
Yes, yes.
God needs to shake us up to get us out of our comfort zone.
Yes.
And see whether or not we're truly going to trust and believe in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, when that storm comes in our life.
Yes.
He wanted to prove to them that they were with him. And if he is with them by their side, then he's not going to let anything come their way. But on that night, he was victorious. Because he tested their faith and showed them that they had to have faith in him. If they didn't trust and believe that the words that came out of his mouth were going to stop the waves, they wouldn't have woken up. In your life, there will be some storms that God allows to happen. It's not to destroy you, but it's for you to trust in him ever the more. To recognize that he has all the power in his hands.
Amen.
You must understand that he has a great plan in store for you, and you. The disciples didn't understand whose presence they were in the midst of their storm. But I challenge you today, are you going to be the one that don't understand who is in the midst of your storm? We see that the disciples had the one who created the sea. Just like we have the one that created the sea, do we trust and believe in him when we're going through that storm? The disciples had the one who was the creator of the storm, the one who stirred the ocean and caused the waves to come. We forget sometimes who we are when the storm keeps raging in our life. He's the one who's going to step out and take control of what we're going through in this life. God didn't just merely put us into existence. He didn't merely just make the stars. But he molded everything. He molded everything that we have on this earth in the palms of his hands.
Yes.
Just like he's continuing to mold us. But he wants us to continue to trust, believe, and obey.
Yes.
Because there's no other way to be happy in Jesus.
Yeah, come on now.
And we don't trust and obey.
All right.
We see in the book of Psalms, the 61st chapter and the 2nd verse, it reads as follows. For the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Sometimes in this life when we're going through our storm, we need to go back to that rock. And when we go back to that rock is going to strengthen us. That rock is going to empower us. That rock is going to encourage us. That rock is going to transform us. That rock is going to move us. I like in the next verse how it says, for thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in the tabernacle forever. But I like how it goes and says, I will trust in the covert of thy wings. In the covering of thy wings. Selah. Saying no matter what we go through, no matter what storm, whatever challenge we may face, that we're going back to our source. We're going back and trusting and believing in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. No matter how hard that challenge may be. But many times we go into that mode where that we think that we can handle that particular situation on our own. But God says, I'm still in control.
Yeah.
I still got this.
Yeah.
But I need for you to just trust and believe in me. In Proverbs 18 and 10, we see that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run unto it. And when they run into it, they are safe. I am reminded of another passage in the book of Matthew as well, the 14th chapter. And it starts in the 24th verse. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves from the wind, was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "Is it a spirit?" And they cried out of fear. Once again, they had that fear to come upon them. But straightway, Jesus spoke unto them, saying, "Be of good cheer.
Yes.
It is I. Be not afraid."
Yes.
Many times when we get into that storm, we take our eyes, we take our self-worth off of Christ. And we are fearful. Yes, we are fearfully and wonderfully made. But we are fearful when those hard times come.
Yes.
But God says, "I don't need you to be fearful. I still need you to just trust and believe."
Yes.
And if you travel with me just for a little bit longer, in Matthew, that 14th chapter and the 28th verse, I like when Jesus gets to talking to people. And he says, Peter answered him and said, "Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water." And he said, "Come." And when Peter was coming down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind start to boast, just like when things start changing in our lives, we started to become afraid, just like Peter did. He was afraid and he started to sink. He cried saying, "Lord, save me." And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and he caught him. And he said unto him, "Oh," once again it says, "thou of little faith, where do thou though doubt?" And when they were coming to the ship, the wind ceased. When Jesus reaches out his hands to us, those challenges, those things that we are facing in this life, they're ceased. Because we know our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, is in control. And we know that when Jesus is in our boat, when Jesus is in our rope, and when Jesus is in our life, that storm that we may be facing or going through has to stop.
Amen.
That storm has to cease. That storm has to go. When we call on our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and we ask him to rebuke those things that are going on in our life, I trust and believe that God is going to rebuke those things that we are enduring or going through in this life. We know that when we go through our storm, we go through those challenging times, that all we have to do is just call on our Lord and Savior. And he's going to just stretch out his arms immediately unto us. But many times we are so fearful and we take our minds off of God. We take our sight off of what God has in store for us. But once again, God still reaches down and he still picks us back up.
Yeah.
Even though we do some things that are coming unto him, he still looks down upon us and says, "That is my son, that is my daughter, that is my child that I'm going to still reach down and pick up out of those trenches and bring them back unto me." Sure, it may get rocky at times in our life. Sure, the way may seem that we can't handle it anymore. Sometimes we may feel that we are lost, that we can't endure it anymore. But our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, all he says for us to hang on in there.
Yes.
Hang on in there.
Yes.
Because trouble doesn't last always.
Yes. Yes.
Hang on in there.
Yes.
Hang on in there. And put your focus back on there.
Yes.
Though I walk through the shadows of death,
yes,
I shall fear no evil.
No evil.
Because greater is he that is within me,
yes,
than he that is,
yes,
in the world.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
He is your source.
Yes.
He is your strength.
Yes.
He will carry you through.
Yes, he
whatever you may be facing in this life. Remember, God is your refuge and strength and very present help in your time of trouble. God has a perfect plan in store for you, for us all. His plan is to prosper you and not to harm you. His plan is to give you hope and a sound future. You know, people, we look at Brother Job in the Bible, and we see that Brother Job went through several storms. He lost his home. He lost his children. He lost his wife. He lost his friends. And he lost his health. And did you know that what Job said, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. The storm didn't bother him. So why should we let the storm continue to bother us in this life? When finally got Job's attention was that in this life we have to lay aside everything and to truly trust and believe in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We have to let go of everything and trust and believe in Him, because He is our way maker and our storm. He is our deliverer in our storm. He is our way. He is the truth. And He is the life. But we know Job thought, well, maybe God doesn't care about me. God let all these things happen to me. Like many of us say when we have our pity parties or that, woe is me. Why me, God? Why has it happened to me? Why am I having to endure this, God? I thought when I became a Christian, everything was going to be so easy, that I was going to be able to live on Easy Street. But God said, I'm not going to put us on Easy Street, but I'm going to allow you to have some troubles, some trials, some storms and situations that are going to happen in your life. God said that we have to endure some things in this life. Each and every one of us are going to have something that we're going to have to go through. Something that we're going to have to endure. But when we go through those trying times and those enduring times, all God is merely asking for us is to give it to Him and let Him be in control. Not let us intervene on our behalf and try to change the situation, but to give it to Him and to count it all joy. That God is still yet in control. We know that God made everything, and that everything is good and pleasing unto His sight. But we also know that the devil still comes to kill, steal, and destroy in our lives. But we can't let the devil get the joy in our lives. We have to give it all to God. And continue to call out the victory in our life. To let God know that whatever He calls for us to do in this life, that we are ready to face it. That we are ready to endure the storm. That we are ready to put on that whole armor of God and to stand fast and wait for God to call on us. Because God is in control of our storm. But we, oh saints, we have to give it to Him. That's the one thing that God wants for us to do. To give it to Him and let Him change the atmosphere, change the situation. And let God do what He said He's going to do. If we take it to God and believe that God will do it, God will surely make it come to pass. If He can do it, if we can't do it, we know that God can do it. Because nothing is too hard for our God. Anything is possible with Him. You may think your storm is overwhelming. You may feel like you are losing your mind at times. And you can't see your way out of the storm. But God is the great I Am. He is the Alpha and He is the Omega. He created the universe and has all power. And has all power in His hand. He is called our advocate. He is called our high priest. He is called our true and living vine. He is called our almighty. He is called our redeemer. He is called our prince of peace. He is called our counselor. He is called our bright morning star. He is called our great provider. He is called the way.
Yes.
He has called
Come
us
on,
to stand
yes.
We know that our God, our God, never fails.
Come on.
We know our God, can take on any storm that we may face in this life. So I challenge you this day, church, to don't let your storm cause you to be separated from God. Don't give up because God hasn't given up on you. Keep on pressing forward. Keep on moving because God has a purpose. God has a plan. And God has a way to take us out of any situation we have gotten ourselves in. God has not forgotten you, but you are in preparation for a greater purpose for God. Amen.
Amen.
If you want to know God today and know how faithful our God is, when we have an altar call, it's your opportunity to come forth or to stay at your seat and ask God to just come by your room. To ask God to just come into your life and change whatever storm or situation you may be facing. And let our just God take control. All we have to do today, saints of God, is to give it to God and let God have his way in our life. Let God have his way in our situation. Let God take his rightful place in your life. Give it to God and let God take control. And stop sweating your storm. And let God be in control of your storm.
Yes.
Let us pray.